agreement, and while they are without a doubt steps that could secure security of life to the citizens of the citizens of a nation, the threat to citizen often come from destruction or deprivation of the most basic overlooked sources. In this case, the source is of water. It has been long been established that water is essential for the existence of life. It is not presence of air or sunlight we desperately seek on other planets, but water, for only where there is water can life be in existence. The significance of water encompasses all, and therefore so does the problem of water scarcity, both nationally and globally. The dire water shortage has led to recognition of a right to water itself, for there can be any life at all without water. All living organisms on this planet are dependent on water for their survival. More than 30% of the human being itself comprises of the water. It is well known that human beings can survive longer without food than without water. Subject to varying weather conditions, animals, plants, and even the smallest organism requires the water. The absence of water is one of the primary reasons why, even if planetary body were to have an atmosphere, there would be no life. Water is what life was made for, and this is recognized by Holy Quran. I quote, "Did the disbelievers not observe that the heavens and the earth were closed when we opened them, and we created from water every living thing? Would they still not believe?" This is the ordained by the Holy Quran. Being an agrarian economy, water is highly important for Pakistan, particularly when it relies upon a single source, that is the Indus rivers and its tributaries, to cater to almost all of its water requirements. Our nation now faces a water crisis. According to the World Resources Institutions, Pakistan will rank 23rd, I repeat, 23rd out of the top 33 most water-stressed countries by 2040. Pakistan Bar Council, Pakistan Council of Research in the Water Resources has opined that Pakistan may run dry by 2025 if the present conditions continue. Pakistan touched the water stress line in 1990 and crossed the water scarcity line in 2005. And relatively little has been done to improve the supply or use of water. The compounding evidence of urgency of the situation is the recent intra-governmental panel on climate change report, which has been hailed by the scientific community as final call to the action. If the global temperature increases by merely 2 degrees Celsius by 2021, we can expect to face resources shortages, famine, droughts, natural disaster, extreme weather conditions, increased spread of diseases, damage to delicate ecosystem, and an increased rate of glacial melting. Pakistan is particularly precariously placed in this context, with icy mountains to the northern, deserts to the southwest, floodplains in the northeast, an expansive coastline to the south. Flooding and drought are increasing risk if the river system is not effectively managed or restrained. Therefore, it is pertinent that Pakistan immediately begin to adopt measures to resolve the problem that contribute to the water scarcity. The right to water forms the part of the fundamental right to life and must be guaranteed to the citizens of Pakistan. as a custodian of the Constitution, the judiciary must ensure that such right is enforced, particularly considering the grim and precarious situation that Pakistan is in the moment. Thus, recognizing the importance of water for the preservation of the life in Pakistan, the Supreme Court has recently passed a judgment in which we have highlighted the risks posed by the water scarcity and its security, and directed that the executive to take all necessary steps to commence construction of Dya Mir Bhasha and Mohammed Dam. In this context, we have appealed to the nation to contribute to an account set up specifically for this purpose, and I must state that we never realized and we were absolutely overwhelmed by the positive reception and the public response in the form of generous donations for this national cause, and the nation's confidence reposed in and respect extended to the Supreme Court of Pakistan. Let me pause here for a while. While these donations were being given, I have come across so emotional experiences that I can never explain. I have received donations from the people who are pensioners and whose pension is 5,000 rupees per month. I have received donations from the little kids who might be having few rupees as their pocket money sum. They have collected these donations from their neighbors, even from their servants also, when they come and explain as to how, what kind of a passion they have for the construction of this dam. I'm sure, and I'm really not banking upon the donations. I know that we would not be able to meet the massive amount of money which we need for the purposes of the construction of these dams and further dams which we need to construct. But I must say that this, in fact, the collection of donation, this attempt on part of the Supreme Court of Pakistan has resulted into a campaign. The people have started thinking about what the importance of the water in the life is. How should we manage? How should we control? How should we be managing the water use? I myself have started using the water while I'm having a toothbrush in the morning. I normally now stop my tap and use it only once for rinsing. And second, when I'm shaving, I don't keep the water tap open and rinse my razor all the time, but rather now it's a cup in which I put some water and rinse my safety or my shaving kit over there. So this is something which we need to understand. This is the life. This is expedient for a life, sine qua non. It is a matter about our existence. And this is for the nation now to come forth and come forward for the purposes of securing the life of one's own self, the life of the posterity. This is for the, I would say, for the prosperity of our posterity, that we need to conserve water, we need to spend water, we need to manage the water in a way that we must, as an agrarian society, use the water for our irrigations, for our agriculture, so that we can have the produce, because the mouths to eat are increasing. The mouths to eat are increasing, but unfortunately, the product, which is all dependent upon the water, I don't think would be increasing if, unfortunately, we do not resolve, or fortunately, if we do not resolve this issue of our problem with regard to the dams. It is only fairly recently that the nation as a whole has become aware of the severity of the issue of water scarcity and security, and it is very unfortunate that the seriousness of water issue has not been talked about more in the past. However, we are never to say that it is too late. Hence, the Supreme Court of Pakistan decision to hold this symposium with the Law and Justice Commission, albeit in the midst of the unprecedented water crisis affecting not only Pakistan, but also other countries of the world. I again pause here to make a comment. Let me, sir, openly, boldly, courageously say that unfortunately this has been a criminal negligence for the last 40 years that this very important aspect, which was the need of the day, which was the requirement of the survival of the nation, existence of the nation, that this water crisis has not been attended to and the dam construction has been delayed to this an extent. So today is the time which I would very clearly tell you as being in a position to say so, that today is the time, do or die. And we are not going to die, sir. We are going to live. And it is for our posterity that we have to contribute. We have to make all the efforts and endeavors for the purposes of making the dam, because we cannot let our posterity to live a life which would be miserable. And if it is so, I think we would be doing no gain, nothing good to the leading and leaving no legacy to our posterity. Coming back to my written portion, this symposium is being held to remind everyone that water problem faces are real and presses and most must be solved at this stage, lest our beloved nation becomes a victim of drought, floods, and climate change. Our aim is to summarize expert knowledge and experiences in the water resources management, and we also intend to consider new ideas, approaches, methodologies to find a concrete solution to ensure water security for Pakistan. This would help the government to effectively prepare nation against future hazard phenomena, including drought and floods. Fruitful talks and discussions are expected to take place to advantage the existing knowledge on critical issues pertaining to water resource management, which would have a significant impact not only on the current Pakistan practices in Pakistan, but also across the globe. At this juncture, I would take the liberty to discuss the main theme underlining this symposium, and I am certain that the experts we have invited are the best placed to guide us on this matter in depth. The first theme feature discussion on the historical perspective of water sharing challenges of Indus River Basin and Indus Water Treaty, 1960. The primary goal is to formulate a roadmap to protect the Indus Basin as a national asset and to see clarity on the current status of the Indus Water Treaty and the Water Apportionment Accord of 1992. This is important because the bulk of Pakistan water policy must be formulated to suit its unique political and geographical situation, which cannot and should not be done in isolation. Rather, in the context of Indus Water Treaty, the Water Apportionment Accord, and peculiar feature of the Indus River Basin, which must be taken into consideration for its effective measurement. The second and the third theme relates to the construction of the dams and the reservoirs, which is of paramount importance for the Pakistan and the challenges that may be faced in their construction, including finances. I believe that judgment of the Supreme Court regarding the construction of the Diamir, Bhasha and Mohammed Dam serves as a suitable starting point for this concentrated effort to reform Pakistan water policy. Undoubtedly, there are obstacles to the completion of this initiative. However, it is my hope that through the course of this symposium, we are able to come up with a concrete and practical roadmap for Pakistan program of building water storages and infrastructure across the Indus Basin and for financing such programs. The fourth and the fifth theme, which will entail discussions pertaining to the best practices conserving, managing, a recharging of the groundwater and the pricing imperative for different uses in key water sector as to how water is governed and managed. In addition to exploring the novel way of fundraising for the dam construction, it is essential that we formulate and implement an effective fair water pricing model. It is no longer feasible to allow unfettered access to our most valuable resource with no incentive to check usage. Pakistan, as I stated, is an agrarian economy and thus requires vast quantities of water to bolster its economic growth. The key to formulating an effective pricing system is making sure we take into account the industrial and agriculture water requirement and do not hinder productivity and people's livelihood in pursuit of conservation alone. We have invited speakers to advise us on water pricing methods and hope to reach a consensus as to which method is the simplest and the fairest to implement in Pakistan's agrarian economy. Polluting these resources that we currently have will only increase in the strain we will feel in the years to come as our population grows, thereby resulting in an increase in the demand. Regulating the dumping of industrial waste, eliminating the littering in rivers, and the responsible sewage disposal will assist us in preserving the precious amount of clean water we currently have in the rivers. Untreated waste contaminated groundwater supplies and health relating issues in drinking water and also the use to irrigate the crops. These are the steps which would resolve our issues. It is also important that the extraction of the groundwater is regulated through various policies. I'm sorry to say that those policies are yet not in place. As the situation currently stands, groundwater is relied on for irrigation due to unreliable canal supplies. This drains aquifer, which in turn causes, amongst other things, increased cost of extraction, shortage, depletion of lake and stream water flow. I hope this symposium will provide some guidance as to the benefit and hindrances of these policies and that we may reach a consensus on how to regulate groundwater extraction. Pakistan's economy, ladies and gentlemen, is dependent and relies on growing water-intense crops. The irrigation system is poorly managed with a great deal of canal seepage and no effective sprinkle system. This is a governance infrastructure and the education issue which results in large quantity of water wastage. More efficient irrigation system as well as less water-intense crops ought to be considered. A very important aspect of the water issue is implementation of various water policies.
Chief Justice Saqib Nisar ka khitab aapne suna. Abhi yahan waqt hua ek break.